He's like, come on then, I'll show you where you I'll pay you the money, honest. Yes, I'll show you where you need to go.
All right, mate. Show us.
Get out down.
Okay. He's gone. Okay. Boop.
He's not with us.
We're waiting on Clint and Chris.
Clint and Chris.
Sorry.
I'll move Chris for now. I think he's restarting. Okay, so we'll just wait for Chris to... Yes. I still got my voice going in there. Hold on, I need to change my Okay, so you get to this door and you see this door that is locked on.
Hello, guys. How are you?
There we go.
So you're in front of a locked door.
Oh, of course it's locked.
Is there people around?
Yeah.
Well, it's a normal sort of morning. You know, there are people wandering about. You notice that you are actually standing. You'll notice that. Don't look too far at the map because I haven't finished everything yet, but you see those two sentry boxes.
Uh-huh.
There's a couple, and that looks very much like a prison.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a couple of guards in the sentry boxes. But
Are they similar to the Scotland Yard ones or whatever, you know, the guys who can't move? No?
The guys, well, you can try and find out if they move. They have armor and spears and things.
Okay, I have an
Do
idea.
Do they have any keys on them?
Yeah. How about that? I turn to Fiber and be like, hey, mate, you look around the house. If there's like a secret entrance, I'll distract the guards. And I'll do a little sexy dance.
Can I go behind the guards and see if they got any keys?
Oh, you can do that.
No, you can't, because that's a sentry box that's attached to the front of the wall.
It's like, it's unfortunate, it's completely like closed, so
they're kind of watching that. They're watching this. Well, can you roll me a charisma check or a performance check?
No.
Make them go out and I can steal from them.
Yeah, well, I'm trying. Trying to grab the attention.
Oh, well, roll me a...
Rolling.
14.
Not great.
Oh, they're watching you.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, I'm doing the trampy dance. Some really bitchy, low down dirty.
Hey, Chris.
Can you do it?
Hey.
Can you
hear me?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's because it's on the phone or if it's just working on the computer now.
Well, I had a similar thing. Anyway, at the moment.
There's no echo.
Your female elf friend is distracting these two sentries outside the prison.
I'm shaking my butt.
And you guys
I got a roll
standing...
for that?
Well, your friend is doing it for you.
Yeah.
She's,
but you can join me if you want to. Shake your ass.
And I'm hiding behind them, trying to, as soon as I get an opportunity, see if they got any keys and steal them. And I guess Glenn is distracted with something else.
They're pretty distracted.
Okay. I'll help distract then.
Yeah, come
on.
Is
that a persuasion or just charisma?
Performance if you've got it.
I don't, so straight charisma.
Straight charisma.
Oops. And that's a die gone. 16 plus 4.
Gee, yeah, that's good.
20.
20 is what I meant to say. Yeah, these headphones have been crapping out. Sorry.
It's alright.
That's alright. By the way, you notice, by the way, as you get up, there are these large windows as well as the door.
While they're dancing, and so I feel a little.
The bus guards are. Ooh! One of them looks at you, Bieber, and he sort of says, "Whoa, what are you doing?"
Me? I'm just walking around. Is that a crime?
Well, can be. Are you social distancing?
I'm trying, but you're the one approaching me.
I can see. I think you're approaching my sentry box, and you shouldn't really be here unless you've got business with the prison.
I didn't know this was a prison. I saw this place. You have a really pretty box in which you work, and I thought I should get one of these for myself sometime.
Oh, I'd like to get some books, eh?
Yeah, maybe someday. I'm successful in my job as you are. Ooh, and you show me around your box.
he's like, look, you distract me. I'm supposed to be on guard duty, you know. We've got lots of dangerous prisoners inside. You know, go on about your business.
I'm going to, like, look around and see. There's nobody there. You're working just fine. Can I see your box now?
There's not much to see. It's just, you know, your standard sentry box, which is just there to keep off the rain.
I'm just trying to distract him and to try and see, check out if he has any keys or something I can steal from him.
He doesn't appear to have any keys. He's got the standard sentry, you know, shield, rusty sword, rusty armor, spear.
You're doing a better job at distracting him than I am, so I guess I go around the house.
You're gonna be like, all right, nice bugs you got there.
I'll really stay in front and keep distracting.
Right. Hopefully someday I can get a nice box for myself.
It's the baton.
Are you able to move your character? What's up with NPC? Hold on a minute.
I forgot how to drag and drop it.
Hold on a minute.
I was clicking the picture.
Yeah, that's how
it works. Hold on a minute. Determine by character setting.
There she is. Fabian's video is pushing everything up here. Oh, whoa. It's really laggy here. Sorry.
Okay. I've just moved you. Can you see you now?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, you got it? Can you move,
I think so. I could... Yes. Yes, I can.
Okay, well, what's your name? What's your name? Put your name out. You. Lena.
Yeah?
You noticed there was another window around the back.
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go there while the guards were distracted and stuff and peek in.
Okay.
Anything good?
You have a peek in. Okay, yeah. Just a minute. I've got to get used to this software. You have a peek in and you can see a room.
Well, I'm peeking from this window too.
You're having a peek from that window. You can see a wardrobe and what looks like the back of a staircase.
Alright. Anybody in the room, though?
Well, can you see the...
Yeah, there's like a green skull
ugly
dude.
Ugly skull dude, yeah.
That's not good.
Ugly skull dude is actually a very ugly troll-like woman.
Uh-oh.
Extremely ugly. She's sitting behind this desk with a big egg timer on it, a big book open in front of it. Looks like a sort of appointments book as far as you can see.
Alright, could I cast message on the troll lady and tell her that she needs to go to the toilet? Like an inside voice, like, maybe I should go to the toilet.
Yeah, you know, I forgot the drawer on this map. I forgot to put in the toilet, and I was thinking I need to put in the toilet.
outside the city, 2 miles away.
Or I don't know. For an hour. Just maybe okay. I need to change my diaper or something. I don't know.
Okay, so that's a good idea. So you send this message, like, so tell me how that's gonna happen.
The spelling itself. Yeah, so basically I take out my arcane focus, just do some magic and point at her and tell her like, I should probably change my diaper. It's been a while. Just like an inside, you know, like an inner voice in her mind.
Okay. So is that actually in sending? Is there actually a sort of persuasion thing fitted in that, or is
it, I mean, yeah, if you rule it so, then yeah.
Okay, well, can you roll me a intelligence?
Okay.
Intelligence. Oh boy.
Yeah. I think.
That's not my forte. Straight intelligence. Wow. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You're screwed.
Are you good at four?
I mean, it could have been worse.
She's like, she takes this cup of water off her desk and she's just like, drinks it, puts it down.
Oh, shucks. Stupid trolls. Okay.
Well, how about we just knock on the door?
Yeah, I'm going to come here and knock.
Okay, you knock on the door.
Knock, knock, knock.
And a voice from the inside says, yes?
Excuse me, I want to ask some questions.
What do you want to ask me about?
Well, it's kind of delicate. I would prefer to be inside.
Oh, ladies' issues, eh?
Yes, a little.
What is this? Are we having a Me Too moment?
No. But maybe, I don't know. It's complicated.
Oh, yes. Yes, well, hold on a minute, and you hear, hold on a minute, I gotta get on here.
Just remind me why we were trying to get in.
Because you've got to come in and steal, Filcher's contract and his chain of office.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, very good.
For his loan, he's got a loan out with Marlowe, and, he wants to get the contract back for it, and he's gonna pay you lots of money if you do it for him. Yeah, well, she unlocks the door. She says, do come in, take a seat.
Thank you.
I'll come in.
Okay. And what are the rest of you doing?
I'll go in.
Okay. Can you move your guy? Do you want me to move it?
I can move.
Well, I
discovered why it wasn't working. It was putting it on the end of the board, which wasn't visible in my screen.
Okay.
So now I have a backup.
Oh, you're there. Is that the one you want to use? It's fine if you want to use that one.
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I'm already at the table.
Yeah.
There are two of them now.
Okay, what about Lena? What are you doing, Lena?
I'll stay outside for now.
Keep watch.
Yep.
And she looks at her appointment book and she said, ah, yes, you're here to steal the documents. Okay. And she takes that big egg timer and she just sort of turns it over and smiles at you with her troll-like face.
Excuse me? What did you make with that? I came to talk to you. I'm not trying to steal anything.
I got in my appointment book, Band of Adventurers Stealing Documents for this morning.
Who wrote that?
Well, then
what kind of secretary do you have?
Humor us?
Pardon?
If you just give us the documents, it's not stealing.
Yeah, if you got an appointment, then...
But then if I just give you the documents, it's not stealing, then my appointment book's wrong, and my appointment book is never wrong.
So, let's play a game. Can you just give us a clue of where are the documents?
Well, where do you normally keep documents?
In my desk, and I'm gonna go come closer to the desk.
Okay, she's like looking at you.
She's fine.
She looks at the sand as it's sort of running out, running from the top to the bottom.
Just out of curiosity, what's your next appointment?
Next appointment? Well, Mr. Scythe and Mr. Grimm and Mr. Reaper are away on business at the moment, so the day's pretty free. Yes, we have. Oh, we've got some business to finish for Mr. Marlow, of course.
Oh, are you a friend of Marlow?
He's an established client.
That doesn't answer my question.
It's the only answer you're really going, you know, do I look like a friendly kind of a person? I'm a receptionist. I don't have friends.
I think you look very friendly.
Yeah, you're a very nice person.
I'm a receptionist.
Yeah, I know how it is. I'm going to commiserate with her.
Okay.
Persuasion. Just gonna try to win her over to my side, so it's plus 6, whatever this result is.
Okay.
It says rolling. It's not rolling.
You have a normal dice? You wanna roll up? So
yeah, I got a normal die. Alright. So that's a 6. Plus 6, 12! Persuasion! Yeah, I know how it is. Why don't you just give us a hint? We'll ramble on after we get the documents, and you can have the day free.
Oh.
That 14 would have been nicer.
Freedom.
I got a 6.
She sort of just looks very pointedly at the stairs.
I am smart enough to pick up on that. Maybe the documents are upstairs.
Maybe the trap is upstairs. We'll never know. Can I take a quick look at the desk and see if there's anything interesting?
I'm going to walk a little closer to the woman.
She's a woman is a generous description.
Big creature.
Ugly troll-like woman.
Like
very troll-like woman. Like.
So it's a troll.
So basically, it's a female troll, but more intelligent than your average troll.
A trollop.
A trollop, yes, it's a trollop. I think she's just got a name, Trollop. Her name is Trollop the Troll.
Trollop the Troll.
Yeah.
I can't take credit for that one, but.
Yeah. The creativity is far beyond the scope.
So, tell me, what is your name? Troller?
Trollop.
Trollop.
Yeah, I never knew that.
Is there a Mr. Trollop?
Yeah,
and I wink.
Well, there was, but I ate him.
So you're free now,
huh? Mind to have a little snack?
Alright, I'll leave this one to you, Bard.
She blushes a deeper shade of green.
She blushes green.
Yeah.
Well, she's green, right?
And she sort of lips her she licks her lips a bit. She said, I like you.
Yeah, so if we can get done with this, maybe we can just, you know, get on with it. You
wink. She's like, no, I couldn't, you know, I'm not your type.
How do you know that?
Because what race are you again? You're a halfling.
Halfling, yeah.
You're a little small for me. you might get damaged.
Oh, I'm not afraid of that. I'm small, but I do pack a punch.
Right. She's like,
well, that's going on.
I like you.
NPCs going upstairs.
Okay.
I'm kind of covering the stairs, like I'm flanking her. So I can leave some space for NPC to pass.
Okay, so NPC, you head up the stairs. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this, because I'm not sure if I can split party. I think there is a way of doing it, splitting the party, but I can't remember how you do it.
Because you never split the party.
Well, do you have another scene prepared? You can just drag and drop.
I have other things prepared, yes.
I think you can just drag and drop people.
Ah, it's the name, isn't it? You drag the name in, don't you?
I think so.
Well,
if NPC is going up there, I'll probably join her after casting Misty Step to go to where she is on the stairs.
Okay.
If you let me do that.
Okay, just a minute. Can I just get into here?
Right there.
Okay, guys, but I'm not familiar enough with this program to split the party, so I'm just gonna move you all across, and I'm just gonna make a DM ruling that you all shift over, go up, and next time we'll see if we can.
I almost scored.
You almost scored. Have you guys appeared on this page yet?
I see a page, but
page hasn't appeared on the page yet.
Your icons haven't appeared on the page.
I can just drop it there.
Yeah, drop them on there, please.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
All right, let's see. I see a lot of black.
Yeah, well, you should see a staircase.
Edge.
At the top, you should see a staircase.
Maybe. These videos take up a lot of room. I see.
Set the videos. You can set the videos to name only if you go in the options. If you go into the settings on the right. And you go down, you can set them to name only, and you can set them small.
As I go up, I just look at the troll and say, call me, and wink, and then hide behind Clint.
And she's like,
so NPC should be in the corner there.
It's a 25 to hide.
Video.
Are you on yet, Chris?
It should have done. The name was there. I think it might be in the corner again or something.
I don't see you. Why did I mess
it
you up?
It put me in a weird place last time.
Well,
it's dragging and dropping. I'm just not seeing the character. Is it under the black, maybe?
I don't see you anywhere.
Because it was set like way in the corner.
I don't see you anywhere. I'm looking at the screen here. Have you got your screen set to a different? No, you should be seeing what I'm seeing.
I see the staircase and I see the other players.
Okay, but you don't see you.
It's probably going to be another doppelganger around.
Okay, well, doppelgang. You doppelgang?
Yeah. Hold on. There. Just let that reload, and hopefully it'll work better enough without half the screen being covered by videos.
There you are.
All right. Yay.
I think there might be two of you now. Double the pleasure,
double the fun.
Okay, so you get to the top of the stairs. There's another window casting light. You see a corridor, some more stairs going up, and a door on the right.
Two, you know. I'm being super stealthy behind Glenn.
I will walk. I mean, in my logic, if they know that we're going to take something, it's not a stealing, so we're not doing anything wrong. I want to think. However, it's kind of.
The voice calls up, you're doing everything right.
Thank
well,
you.
Yeah, according to the book.
Yes.
Thank you, Martin.
So I try to open this door.
It just creaks open like.
And I kick inside.
And you have a look inside, and let's see, you got that. You see another room. And a big book, couple of big bookshelves.
Do they look only like books or like? Like folders with things.
They're books. They look like weighty, like, you know, leather bound tomes, like leather bound books, all kinds, old, dusty, thick. And you also can see on the top of one of the, on the here.
I can see
you.
Something
here. Yeah, well, because I'm in the wrong thing. Here, oh sorry, here, you see this strange globe-like object that's kind of like glowing. Glowing. And it reminds you of the, when you came through the portal. Uh-huh. It reminds you, the glow reminds you of those patterns that you saw when you were coming through the portal.
It reminds me of the magic, or like, of the, like, demon. Like evil energy.
Oh.
It reminds you of the swirling psychedelic patterns that you travel through, and you can see them inside the globe just traveling along.
Okay, so I say, hey guys, there's something weird here.
Yeah, let me take a look. I'm proficient in these. Last time it didn't go bad at all. Mm-hmm. Alright.
Okay.
Maybe I'm going to use.
Okay, well, unfortunately, Nina, as you were walking across the carpet.
Yeah.
It's
a mimic.
No.
Okay,
I open the door and say, I'm going to look for traps.
As you were.
Okay, how far did I get? Like here?
No, you got to about here, and this black spot you can now see. As you walk in there, there was this light. The carpet just sank beneath your weight, and you need to make a dexterity saving throw.
I do.
It's a pit trap.
It's a pit trap. It's the oldest of traps, and I fell for it. Alright, here we go. Oh, a two again.
Is that all you can draw?
Yep.
You rolled a two.
And a plus two, so it's a four.
A four. Well, unfortunately, you just fell flat.
Can I try to help her? I was more or less close. No?
I'm afraid it probably happened a little bit too quickly for that.
Oh.
She sort of just falls. You see her just fall through the floor like, boom. And you take 5 points of bludgeoning damages and land back down in the reception, in front of the receptionist.
Yep, the e-dice is cursed.
Like sitting on a chair, like.
And she just sort of looks at you and smiles and said, oh, I knew what else I had in the appointment book today. To get the carpenter in to mend that bit of the rotten floorboards.
Yeah, he publishes it.
Sorry.
Yeah. That's alright. Stand up.
Are you
and...
okay down there?
Yeah, I just stand up and walk back up. For sake.
Okay, so I walk in, but I push the carpet with my axe. I have a very big axe, so it's like a like to check if there's any other holes.
So what are you doing? You're just prodding. What are you doing? You're prodding the floor.
I'm gonna help her to check for traps.
Okay, well, can you roll me investigation?
Like both of us, or just one?
Yeah, both of you.
Okay.
Okay. 12.
Okay. Oh, one of my cats is going to move, Jan. My cats is coming down from the loft. You smell your something, don't you, Jan? Yeah. Okay, well, you're pretty sure that there aren't any other traps in the room. What do you got? A 12, yeah.
Sorry, my knee's for some reason taking a while.
Okay.
NPC just kind of walks over to the bookshelf and starts looking for the contract.
It's 9 plus 3.
Which bookshelf?
The one on the top
three,
of the room.
12. the one at the top. Okay, well, you notice that there's very obviously a different bit of carpet poking out from the back of the wall.
Hmm. Guys, there's a very obvious piece of different carpet poking out from behind this bookshelf.
Don't step on it.
Put it.
Wow. Wonder why D20 runs so slow.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Everyone's playing D&D.
Fair enough.
Can you move your character over, Chris?
I did.
Did you? It hasn't moved.
It, which one?
Neither of them. They're both there. They're not up to date. Are they? Oh, I've got. Oh, how many we got? We got one there.
Yeah, there you go.
I've moved. That was me moving you.
I rolled the dice, it says rolling, but it's not popping up yet again.
Oh, the internet has gone slow.
Slack went down today, apparently, whatever
yeah,
that is.
It did. Yeah, we had it in the morning, but that just meant I could sleep in longer.
Alright, for some. I see, so it's probably a performance issue. Okay, well, you see, yeah, you notice that this carpet is like, you know, it's just obviously sticking out from under the wall.
Hmm. Okay, that doesn't seem suspicious at all.
You worked in a bar, didn't you, Chris?
Yeah.
Roll me, what's your passive perception?
I don't know. Wisdom is 12, so plus 1, whatever.
You can smell like alcohol.
Ooh.
You can smell spirits.
It's
a bootleg bar.
Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna check the bookshelf for a book that isn't a book. 6 again, plus 1, 7 for investigation.
Yeah, it's actually full of books. They're all books.
Hmm. There's something behind this
hole?
Bar, this door.
This door. There's something behind
this bookshelf.
Can I take one of the books and have a look at them?
They're all law books.
They don't contain anything? Just random stuff?
Law. They contain a lot of law, as in L-A-W, law, not
L-O-R-E.
You know, law. Yes, not that kind of law. It's all, you know, very dry, uninteresting law.
What if I try pulling the shelves of the wall?
Oh, this shelf, it starts to move. Giddy, 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 giddy. You can see it just moves like that.
Yeah.
Nice.
I think it's a trap. Somebody go in there.
And the smell of alcohol becomes.
Hey, Lena, there's something for you to drink here.
Alcohol. I'm going.
Don't fall in the hole.
I'll go first, just in case. Can't lose my best customer.
Yeah, that's true. But I'm already in there.
But I was already in front of you.
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Yeah.
I'm in follow mode.
Now we're on, I think we're on the same space or something. Alright, it's an empty room.
No, it isn't. it isn't an empty room, it's just the program is not... Oh, there we go, okay. Oh, I had him for a second and now he's gone away again. Oh, this software, is this just me or is this totally clunky?
No,
it's really clunky.
It is clunky.
Okay, then I had him again and he's gone away again.
It's either this or Tabletop Simulator.
But I've done all this work getting all this ready. I didn't spend so much time making all this, man.
It looks very good, though.
Hold on a minute.
Yeah.
It's not working.
It is very beautiful.
I made it all for myself. I didn't live the weekend. Hold on a minute. I know what I'm going to do. Hold on a minute. I'm going to go in. Yeah, and I'm gonna go in. There's a quick way to do it. Yeah, that's the rather than messing around with that. I'll put him in. I'll get him. You go in, and I'll get him. Him go in. Okay, yeah, that's the way to do it. Okay, well, there's a guy. Oops, have I put them in the wrong? You can't see them, can you?
Mm.
They're in the wrong layer. He's in the wrong layer. Hold on. Okay, now you'll be able to see. You see him?
There's somebody there.
Yeah, there's green. What's that?
Banana Man.
Yeah.
And Zorro.
And Zorro.
Or, I don't know.
It's the Sandman Port guy, actually.
Oh no, it's Tuxedo Mask. Okay, there are people behind the bookcase.
Well,
we have an appointment to steal.
Okay.
You might call him a people. You might cleanse your kind of detect evil kind of facility. There's this terrible devil standing in front of you, and you see he's like got this bottle of whiskey in his hand. And,
okay, so I yell to the others. Be careful! I can feel the force of evil coming from this creature.
Alright, you go first.
Not respecting our appointment.
And
I just pick my head and go like, "Hi, we have an appointment to steal. Do you have what we need to steal?"
What are you stealing today, then?
Oh, we're just here for the contracts.
Documents.
For your drink?
Contracts.
I say, you want a drink?
You see,
all along, this is basically a hidden bar. There's like, sorry, I should describe it, that there's just like every type of alcohol and spirit you could imagine. And this other guy is like just propping up the wall and he's like,
what language is he talking?
He's talking
drunk.
He's speaking drunk. Yes, he's speaking fluent drunk.
It's your language.
Yeah.
You know, you're pretty proficient in drunk.
Yeah, let me make you another drink.
What is that drink you're going to make me?
Well, it's called a Shadowdale Sling.
Ooh, how do you make a Shadowdale Sling?
Okay. I'm rolling persuasion. Try to make him on my friendly side. Borrow some of the bottles in the back there. Shaka shaka shaka.
Play a nice song for the background.
I have my yak out because it's like a demon. I'm not going.
Yeah, it is a demon. It is. It's not actually a demon. It's actually a devil. Clemens, can you roll me a
10? Uh-oh. It's basically just gin with a little tiny piece of lemon.
It's something.
Clint, can you roll me a history check?
Oh. History.
Well, it's got a beard, and it looks devilish.
Ah, crap, it's one of those, I forget.
Yes. So, I'm going to step into the room and hit the green guy.
And do what to the green guy?
What the fuck?
I'm going to attack my first attack.
You're just going to attack the cage? Wow, hardcore.
Why did I make a drink?
While I give a prey to Lapandor.
Yep.
Bring the light to this crater.
That doesn't make it right.
Okay, well, roll your surprise attack. I must say that the devil is surprised, and so am I.
So I have two attacks per action. If it's a surprise attack, it's also like double?
Mm-hmm. A surprise attack. If you get advantage, I'm going to say you get advantage because this is just like the last thing this person, this devil was expecting.
Oh, poor guy.
24 to hit.
24, yeah, you hit. First attack. Okay.
And I have two attacks per turn, so.
Okay.
Can I attack again?
Yes, certainly.
You got this.
Pretty hardcore.
The second attack is 25.
To hit?
40 to hit?
25 because it's with advantage.
Okay.
And the damage is 10 again. So a total of damage of 20.
20 points of damage. Wow. Excuse my language. You just like, wow, you were hardcore. You were just hardcore. How much damage again, sorry?
20.
Total 20 on both attacks.
Yep. It was 10 in the first attack and 10 in the second.
So. Okay, well, I think it's time to roll initiative.
Okay.
Are we going to do it with the initiative tracker?
Okay, there was this initiative thing here, wasn't it? Where was it again?
Yeah, left side. It's turn. What's it called? Turn.
Turn tracker?
Oh, this guy.
That
turn
one,
order.
Turn order. That's the
okay.
One.
Okay.
How do you roll in the turn order?
You can go in your sheet and then click initiative if you have it.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And then it automatically puts you in there.
I can't remember how to put these guys in. They won't just go in. Why not?
I think you can just drag them in. Well, maybe not.
Yeah.
Now, I think you can do, like, I think click on the enemies and it should have an option like roll for initiative or something. Like, right click on them or some. Add turn.
Add the turn, there we go.
That's the one, yeah.
Okay, and he got 14. That's that. Okay, and for the time being, this guy, he got a 7. Okay, and have we got NPC?
I still didn't put in my character sheet.
Oh.
Oh.
I think you can roll manually, and I think John should be able to.
Yeah, I can add your turn.
I already rolled, but it's still rolling. For some reason, it's super laggy tonight.
Well, just roll a normal dice.
Okay. 4. Oh, sorry, 6. 6. That's an initiative.
Oh, mine's 100.
Yeah. You can just remove the second one. I don't know why it's there twice.
With a minus 100?
No.
No. I like minus 100. Ah, oh, sorry, that's me in the inverse. Ellen, oh, I just added you there. Oh, that was my fault. I added you rather than Chris.
That's fine. Sorry.
Chris, where's your character? I don't see your character. Oh, there you are. Sorry.
Same spot. Yeah, didn't move.
Okay, I got you. So I got the wrong character there. NPC, you got a 6. Okay. Right, well, that's why you're minus 100. Okay, so game on. And the assassin guy, when you attacked, he just did the usual like drunk kind of. He's a bit like Keanu Reeves. And he's like, whoa! Did I say one? Okay, so, and why aren't we getting them in the right order? Why is this not ordering?
I think you can sort it somehow, like right click.
Okay, so numerically descending, like I said, right? Numerically descending. Okay, there we go. Okay, so Kiba.
All right, I'll walk inside calmly and then look at Clint's madly stabbing the other guy. I'm going to say, whoa, you left him ready for a date with the lady downstairs. I'm going to cast Vicious Mockery on the guy. It's a wisdom 14 save.
Okay. He fails.
2d4, and he has disadvantage on his...
He takes what? 4?
34. Let me roll it. That's well to roll. 6 points.
Okay.
Yeah, and has disadvantage on his next attack.
Okay.
Kind of back up over here. And hide.
But you hide.
I back out of the room. And hide, 22.
Okay. So you're hiding behind the armchair?
Yeah.
Like Doctor Who. Okay, well, the devil. He didn't like that. And his beard, which is attacking at disadvantage, and his beard comes lashing out at Clint's. Does a 19 hit you?
19?
Yes, a 19.
Yeah, it's a
15. Okay, well, you get slashed around by his beard. And he does, let me see, this one. He does 8 points of piercing damage. And you need to make a constitution saving throw.
Okay. Natural
20. Wow, well then you're not poisoned. Nice for you, but then he does come at you with his. Oh, he just picks up a glaive from behind the bar and just has a slash at you with his glaive, but he misses.
Okay.
A confined space, actually. Oh, he should have had disadvantage there, so yeah. He certainly misses.
It's just one attack.
Okay. But I'm going to say he's in a confined space anyway with that glaive, so he's not going to be using it very well. Donet, next the Sandyman the Court character, Qua. He's sort of looks at you all and he's like, whoa, what are you doing to the barman?
Like, you're just asking that?
He takes this bottle and he's going to throw a bottle at you, Clintons.
Okay.
Ooh. 16.
Doesn't hit.
16 hits. Okay.
No, doesn't hit.
A minute. 16 plus something. Okay. 19 hit you.
Yeah,
okay. So he throws this bottle at you and it shatters on your head and you take a massive 3 points of piercing damage.
Okay.
Okay, next NPC.
Yep. Alright, well, I'm closer to the barman, so I guess I'm gonna rage.
Okay.
And just start stabbing him. Like a crazy person.
And then thank you.
Okay, two attacks.
Man. Okay, you're gonna have to.
Okay, two is gonna miss.
Oh
but,
my
god,
there's two of you, Chris. Again.
20.
Shit.
20 hits, right?
20 hits, yes.
Alright, now for that big time damage. 4! Nice! 7 total stabbing damage on Beardo.
Okay. Okay, he's still, you notice as well, you've noticed that he's not taking as much damage as you would expect. Your weapons seem a little puny. Okay, and next, Lena.
Well, if everyone's showing off their new stuff, does the assassin guy, well, is he a fiend as well? Does he look devilish?
No, he looks pretty humanish.
It looks pretty humanish. Alright, well, how about I chuck a fireball in there? For good measure. It's okay, it's okay, I got this. Don't worry.
Right, it is okay. A fireball.
Are you throwing a fireball in a room full of alcohol?
It's okay,
alcohol.
I'll spare you guys. I'll spend the sorcery point if you are that, hung up on that. Alright, I'll spend the sorcery point. God damn you. So... none of my allies get blazed to death, but those two guys probably will.
I have resistance to fire, by the way.
And you have resistance anyways, but you're fine.
I don't.
You're fine, I spare you.
I'm hiding outside the room, so maybe it hit me, maybe it doesn't. I don't know.
Those two guys need to make me a dex saving throw.
Okay, they need to make a dex saving throw. I didn't expect this. They both fail.
Alright. 86, I guess. Let's see.
Okay, for the time being, 86.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, that's. Do I want to reroll?
You said a fireball, yeah?
Yeah, level 3, yeah. The fireball.
What's the area of effect?
That's a 20-foot radius sphere.
And where did you throw it?
I didn't really look, I just chucked it in there. Just casually.
Okay.
How about I spend another sorcery point to reroll? Let's see. I want to, let's say, reload the two and the two ones. How about that? So that would be minus 4, so 23, and let me roll.
20-foot radius is like...
it's pretty big.
Yeah, that's going to be like...
okay, that's minus 4.
That's going to get just like, basically...
yeah.
Finger as well is gonna get.
Yeah, it's fine. I'll spare him too. I can spare like 5 creatures, so I'll spare you. And the full damage. So that's minus 4, 23, but 14 plus. That's 37 fire damage.
37 fire damage.
Yeah, and I have I have bad news for the devil guy. He's gonna take full damage of that.
Well, he's just disintegrating. I mean,
okay, well, never mind then.
He's just completely whooshed. The other guy, oh, he's still there. So how much was it again? Total
37. Yeah, I did 37.
37. Okay, he's still there, but he is like, whoa. But I rolled a 1 for the bottles to resist.
Yeah.
Phoebe, you're going to have to make a dexterity save too, because you were within the blast range. And I'm going to add in another 3d6 of fire damage that you're all going to be taking, including you, Lina.
Oh, yeah. That's true. I'm still there, yeah.
Because this is just fire. So there's, you guys are going to take 13 points of fire damage.
Okay.
No save?
No, I think your reaction... No, I think this is just an explosion. I don't think you're going to get a save against that.
What even me?
Ouch!
I think you behind the chair... No, because you didn't even see it coming. You were hiding behind the chair.
Wait, so how much damage was it?
14.
What did I say? 13.
13.
13, 1, 3.
Okay, 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 okay.
And, oh, he's going to take it as well.
Alright, I'm just going to sit down on the other couch.
And there's extensive damage to the bar. How much money did you guys have?
Money?
Yeah, how much money did you have?
Not
yeah,
really.
Fire up the club.
Like 107 gold pieces. Yeah.
70.
Right. Okay. Okay, you had 107 gold pieces, did you? Okay.
That's just me.
Okay, remember tips. you're in a law office. Now remember these, you're dealing with lawyers. Oh, dearie me.
Oops.
Dearie me. You find that suddenly you're like, you know, where you keep your money, suddenly inexplicably just got a lot lighter.
Hey, get your hands off me. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
What?
And a little piece of paper just sort of floats down onto the floor.
Uh-huh. What does it say?
If you pick it up, it says, receipt for damages, 43 gold pieces.
That's worth one. A fireball.
Yeah, it's worth it. I regret
43 to each or overall?
Total 43.
So we're 4. We can do that.
And you see the assassin looking at his phone. He's like, fuck, may as well.
Everybody loses 11 except me.
Oh, wait, we all lose 11? We don't just lose the full...
It's up to you how the money has been taken from your packs. It's up to you how you divvy that up.
Oh.
The money just, like, evaporated.
Oh. The fuck?
Okay, everybody... we can roll a d20, and the highest gets to keep 1 gold.
Nah. Well, you know what? Sure.
Well, I had 107 gold on my own. I could soak 43.
Oy.
I forget how I did it, but I got some good tips.
Yeah, you got tips at the hotel.
You spent the morning in the bar and made more money than you did adventure.
Right.
High five.
There's a lesson there.
There is a lesson there.
Well, now we know.
Lina gets to keep 1 gold.
Yep.
Okay, so next, cleanse.
Uh-huh.
So you've just been burnt, glassed, bottled, and robbed.
No, not that burn. I have resistance to fire. So I get close to this guy.
Okay.
You told me that he was a human.
Yeah, he is a human. He still is a human, yes.
Can I sense any evil coming from him?
Pretty evil.
So I attack him.
Okay.
So
Lawful evil, if you want. Well, mutually evil.
And also he attacked me too. So.
Yeah. He didn't attack you, he just threw a bottle at you. That's just a friendly greeting when he comes home.
Okay, now, then I'm not going to. No, but he's evil. No, yeah, I'm going to attack it. Look. Two attacks. The first is 25, the second is 23. So both of them.
Yeah, they hit. Yeah.
And the damage should be. Damage is 18.
18. Wow. Well, he's still standing, but only just.
Okay. So that ends my turn.
Okie dokie. Fever. You're hiding behind hiding behind the chair.
Yeah, I'm gonna stand back up, clean myself a little bit, go inside the room and say, are we throwing stuff? I'm just gonna pick one bottle and throw it at the guy.
You just okay. You just moved
just
behind.
Took one bottle at him.
Okay. Well, roll me an attack roll, and you can add your dexterity bonus. Is that your right? Okay.
9 to hit.
That misses. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna keep doing that, so, but I only have one action, so.
Okay. Well, this guy, he's very unhappy, and he gets out a short sword and he attempts to stab Clens, but he misses the first time, and the second time, 19. Does a 19 hit you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, he stabs you with his short sword, and you are going to. You take 8 points of piercing damage and you need to make a constitution saving throw.
Constitution saving 21.
Oh, you make it.
You're running very good today.
You make it, and you are lucky to make it. Because
that's a bad one.
You would probably kill you with one shot. Anyway.
Oh, okay.
So, next up, NPC.
That is me. Roll 20 is still crapped out for me, so I'm going to stab Beardo 2 more times.
Beardo is down.
Draw a bottle.
Beardo is down. He's gone. He's dead.
Oh, well then I'm stabbing the other guy, and it's 2 threes, so 8 armor class probably doesn't hit. So angry.
Throw a bottle.
I'm gonna grab a bottle as a free action, and just later. Not right now, never mind. Just, I stab him twice, and it doesn't work.
You miss spectacularly.
Makes me angrier.
Okay, Lena.
Oh, there's alcohol? Oh boy.
Is well, there's no alcohol left now. You've just.
Aw, poop. Well done. I don't know. The guy's still up. Alright, he gets a firebolt this time.
Okay.
Just a firebolt. Yes. Let's see. Okie doke. That's not how you do it. And there, 7. Does an 18 hit?
18 does hit.
Just hits. Alright, well, good thing we leveled up. Because it's 2d10 now.
Okay.
That's fine, 11.
11 points of damage.
Uh-huh.
He drops dead to the floor.
What happened to my alcohol? Who burned the alcohol? I can smell it.
The entire room is just a mass of broken glass. In fact, what are you wearing on your feet, all of you?
Let me check my picture.
I have shoes.
I have very thick armor, so...
Yeah, yeah, you'd be fine, but I'm worried about Lena and the NPC.
And I have sandals.
They look like pretty serious duty heels.
You're wearing
Not like stiletto heels, but like fine heeled shoes.
Okay, well, you're above the broken glass, but Lena, I think I need you to make a dexterity save.
I was about to go to the beach. I have sandals on.
You understand? Oh, we dexterity.
See there.
Right.
They're like big leather, chunky shoes.
You want chunky shoes?
Huh?
Yeah.
Not my forte. Dirty 20.
No, you're fine. All these nasty... Yeah, you're fine. You notice that there's all these broken pieces of glass all over the place. And you're like, ooh, I don't want to step on any of that.
Yeah. I jump on Tiber's neck.
Rummaging through the corpses to see if I find anything.
On the devil has just disappeared back to hell. There's a smell of sulfur. Hmm. On the assassin, you find a pouch, which did have some gold in it.
Ooh, nice.
Did have some gold in it. Well, there's a little receipt in it. It says for damages incurred in the bar. Oh, and you find another piece of paper.
What does
fold it up.
I unfold it and read.
You see it's a bar tab.
Mm-hmm.
A bar bill.
How much?
How much?
Oh, another 30 gold pieces have gone from your pouch.
Ouch. I just leave the notes in the guy and keep the pouch.
And a little receipt floats back. Payment of bar tab gratefully received. These people are lawyers.
I'm afraid so. This is the worst kind of people.
This is the kind of people that we need to really destroy.
The paladin hates lawyers. I love it.
Me too.
We forgot all about that mysterious glowing orb.
Yeah.
Oh, the orb, yeah. Hello,
can
orb.
Can we put it in a pouch or something without touching it?
Oh, wait,
ooh,
let me.
It's way up on the top of the bookshelf. How are you going to get it down from the top of that very tall bookshelf?
I'm going to throw a bottle at it.
No. No. Bad
no,
idea.
No.
Why not?
No.
No.
It's a nice bowl. Delicate. No. Yeah.
So, if it breaks, it was going to break anyway.
No, but this, no. I think this is important. Let me investigate it.
If I look at the orb, can I perceive if it's like any evil energy coming from it?
Well, you can try an arcana check, I suppose.
I will help you with the arcana check.
I'm just gonna throw a bottle at the wall.
Come out of my rage.
Instead of the arcana check, can I use detect good and evil?
You use what?
It's at the divine sense. As an action, you can detect good and evil.
Oh, you can detect good and evil. Yeah, you can try.
Okay, I use it. I can also know the location of any celestial fiend or undead within 60 feet.
Okay, you do not detect any... just a minute, actually, I'm within 60 feet.
Uh-huh.
Okay, just a minute. Did I forget to do then? What have I got to do then? Good heavens. Another minute. You don't detect any evil or any celestial or any fiends, but you do sort of detect traces that there had probably been such evil beings around here quite frequently. They're not here now, but you're in a law office.
Okay. Lawyer. But the orb doesn't feel like especially evil.
The orb doesn't seem evil. Lena, would you like to try Arcana?
Sure. Let me see if I can recall what I've did last time. With a psychedelic, whatchamacallit.
Psychedelic, whatchamacallit.
Yeah, the psychedelic portal. Arcana, eh? Wow, that's not terrible. But I rolled an 11.
Well, you just like, it reminds you of when you were spinning through that, that portal. I mean, those are the patterns inside. It looks like it's got the same patterning as the portal patterning.
I think this is a portable teleportation thingy. We should take it with us.
I'll give you a boost.
I come up behind you and I put the broken bottle in your hand and just wink at you.
What?
A 9. To lift Lena up.
Lift me up?
To get so you could reach the thing.
Yeah.
Okay, Lena. You roll me dexterity.
Oh, for fuck's sake. What's happening today? Oh, this dexterity saving throws. Oh, well. That's a net 20. 22.
No, that's fine. Because NPC's not very sturdy, and you can see she's like staggering, and like you see that big hole lurching towards you.
Oh, no.
She's like, I got it. You're like, but you do manage to
not again.
Take this blow.
All right.
Yeah, you can take it. You can take it off.
Nice. Ding,
and you've got this, and it's this big, nice globe, and you can see it swirling all around, like, all those patterns, pretty patterns. Not quite sure how it works, but you can see some writing around it.
Oh, which I cannot read, I suppose.
It depends. What languages do you read?
I can read Hellish, Celestial.
Yeah, Draconic or Elvish.
Oh, you read Elvish. You recognize it as Elvish.
Oh. Mm. The language of my people.
Yeah.
What does it say?
It says, I wonder what would happen if... Dot.
Someone threw a bottle at it, and I look at Cyber.
And again.
Do you read it out loud?
Yeah, sure.
There's a little bit of a weird, like, kind of, like, just a little bit of a, like, ooh, wonder what that was.
Oh,
like,
this
a
is
little
a
bit of glitchy.
This is a wishbowl.
Ask it something.
Hey, Cyber.
What will happen if I was taller?
Yeah, it's a wishbowl. What would
is
happen
that
if...
You
for
something?
It's probably a monkey's paw.
A monkey's paw, that's a scary story.
Yeah, it is.
Just when you say, I wonder what would happen, if every time you say that, there's this just like little like weird kind of... I don't know, I'm sure you're all nice people and you've never taken ammonite trait, but it's a bit like ammonite trait. And what was that? And it sort of passes very quickly.
Weird.
Well, we can take this. I mean, we need to focus on our mission here right now. This place is evil. I don't want to stay here for too long.
Yeah, and there's one more.
Wonder what would happen if my knife was magic.
Again, you just get that, like, when you say that in Elvish, you just go sort of, but your knife, nothing happens.
Well, let's go back to this later. Let's check out the next floor.
Okay.
Are these stairs?
These are stairs.
It's like there's a third floor, yeah.
That's where we came up from. I think we used the one that you're close to.
Hold on a minute, right, I shall I shall reveal more, just a second.
Oh, there's more?
There's more. There's, you go up the stairs.
Wait, there's more.
Dun, 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 dun. You see the stairs going up and they sort of turn to the right. Can you see down the way a bit? If you scroll down, you should be able to see more stairs. Yep, yeah, there, that's where you are. Oh, and you see a little old man and he's like sweeping the carpet.
Hello, old man.
Hi.
How you doing?
Fine, as usual.
Ooh, that's great to know. Did you feel the explosion?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting that, to tell you the truth. Normally people that come here, you know, we hit, you know, we get all sorts, you know, arguments, fights, complaints, crying, you know, all kinds of, but I've never actually known anyone blow the place up before. That was quite
It was the bartender's fault.
Somebody was trying something new. I don't know.
No, the bartender was smoking, he dropped a bottle.
That was the bartender.
Yeah.
Yes, he's a devil, isn't he?
Okay, what do you mean? Mind if I ask you, do you have any records of this around here that we can peruse through?
Are there any records?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I'm just, you know, I'm just the cleaner. I don't know anything.
Oh, but as the cleaner, you should know everything.
Well, I clean the rooms, yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen something like that?
Like what?
A room full of
like
parchments and contracts and things like that.
Like important papers.
Oh, there's parchments and contracts. Yeah, of course there's parchments and contracts.
What?
Any room in particular?
No. Just about any room, really. I mean, you could try that door there. There's a parchment and a contract in that room, I think.
Oh, thank you very much for the information.
Yeah, just one thing.
Yeah?
Yep.
I think there's somebody waiting in that room.
Someone waiting?
Is he squiddy?
Hmm?
Is he squiddy?
He's not very, how do we put this? He's not very bright.
Not very bright. Like he's a shadow person.
He's a man of, he's a man of action, and he's got sort of contractual issues that Mr. Scythe is helping him out with.
Mr. Who, sorry?
He's got contractual issues. He's trying to get out of the contract, and Mr. Scythe is helping him at the moment. I wouldn't, you know, he can be a little bit violent sometimes.
Yeah, that can be an issue with some of us, and I look at Clint.
Sorry. Do you have any advice to deal with this person?
Generally, giving him a thumbs up and money seems to help.
Mm.
He likes it when everyone puts their thumb up. He's got this real thing about thumb up. Everyone gives him the thumb up and throws money. He's always really happy with that, and he'll sort of pose in the room with his arms in the air.
Yeah, who wouldn't be happy if you just get thumbs up and free money? That just makes sense.
Hmm? Huh?
Who wouldn't be happy if you just get a thumbs up and money? I mean,
he loves it. That's what that's his job, you know, making money. By killing people, he works in the arena. But he's trying to get out of his contract, you know, and we're just helping him with that. Not that I would know, not that I ever know the people on the desk or anything.
Yeah, I mean, you probably have no idea what's going on.
Oh, you see, there's another guy, by the way, and he's a similar, just old guy. This guy. Yeah? Yeah, this guy, and he's similarly just, these are like the old, the cleaning guys. Just old.
Okay.
classic oriental
looking. Cleaning guys here.
There's always two cleaners. Union rates, you know. You can't just have one cleaner doing one man's job. You've got to have two cleaners doing one man's job. You know that.
I'm not very knowledgeable in unions, but I now want to get into one.
Yeah, but anyway, sure. I was just cleaning in that room just this morning, and yeah, they've got parchments on the desk.
Oh. We'll take a look.
Yeah, we can.
So what are you going to do?
Go to the door. He signaled with the guy of the thumbs up and try to get in.
Pardon?
First knock a little bit.
Oh, you knock.
Yeah.
You knock on the door and you hear like, yeah?
Can we come in?
Not right now.
Sure.
I'm pissed.
Sorry. I'll open the door and the first thing I put is like.
Okay, well, you open the door and sure enough, you can see another room.
Oh.
I love your art, then.
Yeah. It's very psychedelic.
Yeah, thanks. It's very, this is, I did all this with.
Monty Python for some
reason. Looks like an
acid. This is all hand drawn. I drew it all over and then scanned it and then photoshopped it.
Nice.
So I've been passing the time.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah, I like that. I like the analog touch.
Ooh.
Anyway, and you see he's pouring over and you see this guy sitting on the chair, and he's an older guy, but very, very tough looking, covered in scars. He's wearing, you can see, just classic gladiator armor. He's just, you know, he's got his helmet down on the floor beside him, all his weapons. He's got his spear, a shield. He's just scarred up, and he's like pouring over this contract. Like, there must be a way out of this contract.
I'm just gonna walk in and say top of the morning and go and try to find the parchments.
Well, you can see on the desk here. Oh.
There are some parchments in there.
Very nice.
Yep.
Yeah, you see a couple of parchments on the desk. Thank you. Yeah, I just gotta go and get myself out. I'll be back in.
Alright, no worries.
I'm going to stay outside of the room because I'm a little embarrassed of killing everyone in the previous floor.
I'm gonna try to distract this guy. Get the stuff off that desk.
Alright.
Sounds good. Sounds like a plan.
Do your interpretive dance.
Remember the one that Squidward does in SpongeBob?
Squidward.
Ikarudo in Japanese. Ikarudo.
Ikarudo?
Yes.
Hatsumi.
You haven't seen SpongeBob in Japanese?
No, I'm afraid. I'm a pleb. Ikarudo. Magica.
Same joke in every
language. Yeah. Good to know. Oops, wrong button. I hope I didn't waste a good roll.
It was okay.
Oh, you did.
Well, it's electronics, so it's either going to be 20 or 1 next round.
Okay, I'm back. Good. So, share a couple of parchments on the desk.
Hey, mister.
Filcher's name?
Huh?
Anything with Filcher's name?
They're rolled up. They're rolled up. You can't see. They're rolled up on the desk.
MP rocks into the room.
Okay.
Engages the guy looking at the contract.
He smiles.
Persuasion.
Mm-hmm.
What seems to be the trouble, mister?
Well, I've got this contract with the arena. I want out of it.
Oh, there's got to be a way out of it.
That's why I'm here for, but you know what these lawyers are like? Expensive.
Yeah, they take the money right out of your pockets.
They certainly do.
So, I'm basically distracting him.
Okay, he's distracted.
Yeah, I'm looking through, trying to open the parchments and see.
Okay.
Try to read through.
Are you reading the parchment?
Yeah. What's okay. The worst that will happen?
You need to make a wisdom save.
That's pretty bad.
Eva. Oh dear.
Six.
Uh-oh.
Nice knowing you guys.
Fine.
You guys all notice, well, doesn't seem to be much of a change to Thieva, but friends,
mm-hmm.
You really don't like Thieva anymore. He starts emanating evil.
I take my axe now.
Oh, GG.
Lucky for you, I just say when you left, yeah, but I'm outside the room because I feel a little embarrassed that I killed everyone in the previous floor. So I'm kind of outside praying, like, oh, Latander, give me wisdom, give me light. And I'm outside of the room. I cannot see what is happening.
Well, you can feel it, though, and you just feel this, like, surge of evil wash over you. And as you look up, you see, like, it's like... Thieba's face takes on this just like evil slant to it. Thieba, you are now neutral evil.
That's cool.
Wow.
That's apparently the worst that could happen.
Like forever?
No, that remains to be seen. You don't know.
Wow.
You just feel.
I see
evil.
Nothing wrong with these contracts. They make perfect sense.
That's very evil. Well, I suppose when I feel the evil, I step into the room.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you just like... Your friend Thieva, there's something wrong with him.
Oh.
He's
got
help
the
me look, Clint. Look through these papers with me.
I don't think so.
Why not? Like... It's what we came to find, isn't it?
Not really.
What? The contracts! We came looking for a contract. I don't know what you're talking about. Are we gonna leave our good friend Filcher now?
Filcher didn't come with you.
Yeah, where is Filcher anyways?
No, I mean, but...
He was smart.
We came for the contract, Filcher's contract, and we have to look through this. And see if it's his.
Before you keep looking, I'm going to cast Bless.
So, this gladiator guy.
Mm-hmm.
Does his contract have any obvious out clauses?
Only an intelligence check. And Clint, you cast Blur.
Bless.
Bless?
Are you blessing us, huh?
I'm blessing. The three guys.
Can you
bless
him?
So you
that's
have...
not enough. It looks pretty cast iron to you.
Hmm. Yeah, this is a toughie. This... Wait a minute. What are you... You're just a customer here, aren't you?
He looks a little bit like just a customer. I am... Hold on a minute, I remember his name.
Fiesel.
I am...
Oh, Iron
Don't
Man.
Don't you know me? I am Banderinge the Magnificent.
Oh, yes. Of course I know you.
Oh, that guy, yeah.
Banderinge. Everybody knows Banderinge. He stands up and he's like...
Yeah, Banderinge. Yeah, the Magnificent. Yeah, 16. Bluff.
I read about you in the newspaper yesterday. Of course.
Knows you.
Yeah, everyone in the bar downstairs was talking about you briefly.
Of course. I'm the greatest gladiator ever.
Oh, yeah. But a contract is stronger. We really need a lawyer to take a look at this.
Bloody lawyers. Do you know how much they cost?
Yeah. It's just like your gold is evaporating.
Yeah, that's how it feels like to me as well. Yeah, and anyway, they said they're off on business, so I should wait here. And they said I could look through the contract myself and see if I could find... But unfortunately, I can't read. I've been looking through it, but... And you notice that it's like... At the bottom, it's just got this big sort of X scrawled on it.
Hmm. Well, as long as he's distracted, because he's... Wait, is he not guarding the contract?
No. He's just sitting on the seat reading through his own.
Oh, why am I talking
to
this guy?
Yeah, that's why I'm looking at the contracts trying to find out filters.
You can't find filters.
Yeah.
What about what you found, the one you read was nasty and... The rest are actually the blank.
Oh.
And you can see those.
What about in
You have a look in the drawers?
Yeah, they have a look through the desk and
software.
That orb.
Yeah. I have it. Show it.
In the drawers, you just find things like quills, ink, seals, all kinds, you know, wax, all this kind of
stuff.
If.
I would steal these, but I know they're gonna charge me, so I don't bother.
Oh, you wonder if you could make the contract void
appear.
Or appear.
Oh, void the other guy's contract.
Yeah, right.
We're here for Felcher's.
Yeah, I wonder where is Felcher's contract, I say aloud in Elvish.
I wonder where... No, you get no answer, but when you say, I wonder if...
Yeah, wait, the thing is, I wonder what would happen if I knew where Filch's contract was.
Again, you just get that weird kind
feeling
of disruption. And you see, what's his name, Marlorange, he looks at you and says, "Ooh, that's weird."
I know, right? Can't get this happy
fun
ball.
Yeah, you see, looking at his contract, like, that's weird.
Oh.
Really weird. It looks all different now.
Oh.
Hmm?
He's like holding it upside down. It's different.
Take it.
Okay.
I help him out. Turn it the right way up.
Well, you look and you read it before and you realize that it's... Kind of all the writing's just been really weird.
Ah, this orb disrupts the contracts, isn't it? It's like it changes what's in... Ah, that's how these lawyers are doing it. Dirty. I get it.
Hmm.
Freaking people.
Yeah, the orb is the...
Hey, this contract. We could probably get him out of this contract. We could use a gladiator.
Yeah.
Play it with the one I found, and I pass him, like... show him the one I was reading, and see, do something and see if I notice any changes.
The one that you were reading, that turned you evil is now just blank.
Even through the changes, it doesn't, nothing
happens? Yeah, it's just now a blank piece of paper with a little, like, skull mark at the bottom, and, like, a smiley face.
Classic curse, girls.
Yeah, that's reassuring.
I'm gonna keep that one with me. Just put it in one of my pockets.
Okay.
So anything in this shelf over here?
You can see just more law books.
No more contract?
Nope.
Hmm. What about the blank scrolls? Did they get writing?
Nope.
Huh.
Do you want to look at one?
That's okay, I'm gonna pass.
Okay, I get closer to Tyver, and I put a hand on his shoulder and I cast Lesser Restoration.
Tyver? What does Lesser Restoration do?
Lesser Restoration is for conditions and diseases.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if he's going to do something.
Probably not gonna work on a curse.
Yeah, I think it's just for very specific things.
Yeah, should be.
Great. Yeah, there's actually the remove curse spell. I don't know what level it is these days.
That's third level.
Yeah, a little bit higher. Yeah.
But we don't have it.
Isn't it a ritual now?
I don't think so.
Yeah, this restoration is for blinded, deaf, and paralyzed for poison.
Yeah, that's for very specific things, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I can see.
It's an Asuna.
I always
you can see clearly.
You did notice there was another staircase, of course.
Yeah, there's another one.
Of course I noticed. I didn't
well, let's go
miss that in real life.
Good look, you crappy gladiator guy.
Yeah. Come
with
us.
We could probably free him from the contract if we use the orb a couple times.
Yeah. What if I say the words again? I wonder what would happen if I look at his contract. Does it change back?
No, because last time you were talking about contracts.
Ah.
Ooh, it's like a chaos artifact or something.
Yeah.
The mystery deepens.
Dum, dum, dum.
Alright. Did we ask for the gladiator for his name, by the way? What's your name?
We did. We weren't paying attention.
Marlon Orange, the Magnificent.
Oh, yeah, my bad. Yeah, of course. Well.
Next floor?
Yeah, let's go upstairs.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Agreed.
Trying to think.
Okay, so we're going to move maps again.
How many floors are you in this thing?
Hey, I've been having fun. Let's see if you all move.
Okay,
I've just moved you all. Remember.
I should work then. Well.
What do you see? Are you on the board?
No.
I still see the old board.
Oh, maybe
you see a new one.
Yeah, I can see a new one. I mean, I can drop
a shadowy figure.
It started reloading. There we go.
Okay, you're down. Some of you are on.
It's running really slow for me tonight.
I think it's slow for everyone. I think everybody is in lockdown and everyone's doing Wednesday night D&D in the entire world.
The most popular day.
But it was saying there was a script on my side, so it could also be the browser.
Right.
So roll 20 might be better, but my computer isn't. I was thinking of buying a new one, but I want to spend all my money in this quarantine if something happens to our income.
Yeah, likewise. They're like Mombashores, the education thing. So useless. I think I'm going to have to buy a computer for the kids.
Yeah. And this, be careful, these things are sold out now.
I know, everything's sold out. I mean, in the other bash, like, you have to clang your hands to go in and tell them what you were looking for. And, like, all the, like, everything under, like, 70,000 yen is sold. And they're not getting any more.
They're not? Yikes.
Well, it's like me kept it. Like, I think there must give me so many holdups at the moment.
I might have to hop on over to Akihabara to pick up a better computer before those get snapped up.
Mm.
I think you'd be better off online, to tell you the truth.
Oh, there's a lot of stuff in Akihabara we went today.
Yeah, I buy them used.
Yeah, but the used stores have quite a lot of stuff.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, it's not real. You can't really shop online because I know the used store I like.
Right. Okay. Oh, well, anyway, what you should see, at the top of the stairs, you see this long corridor. You see a door on the right, and at the end, you see this massive, hellish-looking suit of armor.
Ooh.
Just standing there, menacingly.
Just standing there, just glowing red light. Not particularly evil, actually, for you, Clint. It doesn't seem evil, but it does seem threatening.
Can I feel the evil?
You just got that normal sense of, you know, lawyer evil.
So the building is evil for me right now.
Yeah. And of course, your friend Fever is now radiating huge quantities of evil.
Yeah, I really want to hit him with my axe, but I won't.
You are fighting your axe, and he's like, you're
sitting. Yeah, I'm like.
And probably, if he's a bard, he's probably just singing like evil little songs that are really unpleasant.
I'm singing an evil song about a horny sailor.
Yeah. And you see a little fly, you catch it, you pull its legs off you. You know, I can make a fly go deaf. You take its foot, swings off, you say, fly, it doesn't fly, look at its head. So what are you going to do?
There's
not
a door.
Approach the door past the armor?
No, the door is halfway up the corridor. The armor is at the end of the corridor. Are you not on this board yet? Can you put yourself on?
No, I can't reset the map here. It's... what the heck?
Can you reload? Why don't you just hit the reload button on your browser and see what happens?
Alright, I'll try that. It took like 20 minutes last time. Alright, well... MP is gonna, I guess, get close to the door.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for the
gingerly
door.
Gingerly.
What browser are you using, Chris?
Firefox.
Okay, I'm on Chrome, maybe.
Yeah, it's probably, like I said, there's some kind of script running that's really lugging it, yeah. So it's not necessarily... Roll 20. It's maybe this Firefox version.
I've just copy pasted your icon onto the board. NPC, NPC, if you can see that.
It's loading. Okay. Since I turned off video, it's going faster, but it's still glacial.
Okay. So, anyway, you see the final door, you see a door.
Open the door.
It takes a step.
Someone needs to get it. Oh! Okay.
I knew that would happen.
Hope someone is oil.
Maybe we could jump in the room and lock the door behind us.
Is that what you're going to do? Jump in the room?
Yeah.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Look quickly for the room.
Yeah! NPC jumps in the room.
Yeah. I'm slow.
And demons attack.
Close the door.
Okay, Lena, do you jump in the room or do you close the door?
All right. Jump in the room.
Okay. This just sort of... Yeah, the door slams shut beside you, behind you, and you feel it, like, you see it just sink into its frame a bit, like an extremely heavy object was leaning against it. And you see a desk which is covered in scrolls. Lucky you.
Let's look for it. The one we came for, Filchers.
Wait, don't look at things, just suddenly be careful.
What am I supposed to do?
I'm going to cast Divine Sense again. I have another tree. Can I sense any evil coming from the papers?
This time, no, you can't, but you do sense magic. Well, they're giving off a bit of an arc. A couple of them are giving off an arcane glow. The
from all of them?
No, this one and this one are just sort of giving off a bit of a glow. This one most definitely isn't, but this one has a big red seal on it.
Ooh, I'm gonna go for that one. Grab it.
Okay, I'm going to grab the one that is like having the arcana healing. I'm just going to keep it away from the rest.
Okay. So you grab the hold on a minute, maybe
guys are being grabby.
Okay.
Well, we came looking for something, but we found the
okay, you find this big one with this big red seal on it. This one in the middle you've just picked up, Fever. It's got this really important seal right on it.
Ribbon. Well, we came looking for a contract. What are we supposed to do?
Be careful.
Being careful, yeah.
Okay, look, here's the contract. Be careful with it, but check that it is the one we need.
Hmm?
I think we can only open it and see what it is.
I guess.
I forgot about animal handling.
What are you
gonna
do?
Nobody stops me. I'm gonna open the scroll. Trying to damage a little bit extra the seal, just in case.
Are you going to read it?
I'm going to unfold it and show it to somebody else.
Well, everything I touched in this house blew up, so I'm staying the fuck in the corner.
I'm going for NPC.
Hey,
what does it say?
Huh? I read it. What?
It says, loan agreement between Pilcher and Marlow, thereby Pilcher agrees to borrow the sum of 2,000 gold pieces from Marlow, surety.
Oh.
Pilcher's chain of office from the Thieves Guild to be held in surety against payment of the loan. The chain of office to be held in, in security in all legalese language. And
escrow,
yeah. And tells you will be held by Grim Reaper and Scythe. And then you see an addendum, and it says, at Marlow's specific request, he's asked to keep the chain of office himself at an undisclosed location.
So, are you like magic powerful or something now?
Am I magic powerful or something now?
Nope.
It's just a normal contract.
Your soul is just slightly being sucked out of
you. I'll take a look at it and seeing that it's filtered, I'm gonna just pocket it. Okay. Time to go, guys!
Have you done?
Is there anything else in this room of note?
Well, you can see
the
desk. You see that. Well, there's the table, and you see that big cabinet in the corner.
Wonder if they have any booze to replenish my stock.
Yeah, exactly. That must be the minibar. I'll roll investigation.
Okay.
I'd love to steal from these guys, but you know they can charge us magically, and I don't like that at all, so I'm getting out of here.
Nine. Yeah, guys, we're not here to steal
investigation.
Everything.
Yeah, nine.
Two nines.
That's 99.
Nine. You know, the cabinet is locked.
If only if he had a rogue.
Especially maybe a neutral evil rogue.
Okay.
With lots of
another thing you notice, in the top corner of the room, here. If you look up the ceiling, you can see that there is actually a some kind of trapdoor.
Trapdoor.
You?
That might come in handy because I think the armor is locking us in.
Yeah, you're not getting out of here.
You want that? You want that thing open?
Yeah.
If you tell me, I can try.
Open everything.
In the meantime, can I try to open the trapdoor?
Well, it's like a. How tall are you?
How tall I am? I should know that. Wait,
I will boost you.
That's a natural 20 for 29 to
That's
open
not a good
the
idea.
I'm 6'3", but I don't know what that means in normal measures.
Well, this is a normal height room, so you know you're gonna need something to
just use all the chairs. Use all
so
the chairs.
You unlock the chest. Do you open it?
I leave them to them. It's open now. You were looking through this.
Oh yeah.
Go ahead.
Alcohol. Okay. Open it.
Well, you don't actually find that. What you do find is another scroll.
Yet another scroll.
Guys, be careful with the scrolls.
Yeah, that one looks old. It might be the Elder Scroll.
Yeah, it's one of the Elder Scrolls.
Is it magical?
No, this
Lena?
One isn't.
Let me check.
This one, you feel your soul drain. Just
Arcana.
Okay.
It's a 12.
On which?
There are multiple? I don't know. All
no,
of them.
There were two on the table.
Nah, like the one
There's
that
the
I
one
found.
In-
The one in the cabinet
yeah.
is not magical, it has the look of another contract.
It's another contract. Alright.
Well, my soul's already dampened, I'll take a look.
Yeah, take a look.
Okay. Well, you see, it's a contract for leasing caves. For Marlow to lease some caves outside of the town. And there's a condition that he cleans out the troglodytes.
So that's why he sent us there. Tricksy bastard.
Curious.
Alright. Let's pocket
we
this
should
one
probably
as well.
Look at the, probably look at the scrolls on the table.
Yeah, look at the other ones.
We should get out of here.
Well, if you look at the ones on the
table,
Clens
is working on it.
This one, you see, is a scroll that has a magic spell in it.
This is a magic spell.
Has a magic spell that can be cast once you recognize Lena. You
yes.
see that this is a zone of truth spell. With a charisma save of 18 required to resist it. It's a power, but will only have one use.
Okay, gotcha.
And this one, you see, hold on a minute, what did I do to this one? Ooh, this is a hold monster spell with a wisdom save 15 with one use.
Wow. Alright.
You see, these are lawyers that don't mess around.
Those are useful. Pocket.
Alright, I guess I should help cleanse. Hold still.
Yeah, I'm trying to move these chairs.
I'm going to jump on you.
Chair.
Why don't we just break 18. A window open?
Jump on the paladin.
Well, we are on the fifth floor.
You move this chair.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, the chair is moved.
Yeah.
and the barbarian.
Hold on, I know what I should do there. Okay, I should
if I can get
this,
in the chair, can I reach the trapdoor?
Ow, my head.
Well, yes, but in your armor, it's a bit of a rickety chair and.
Oh.
You know that you've seen, I don't know if you have them in Mexico, all those helpful public
You have an elf
safety.
On you. Use
They use the table.
All those public safety announcements where it's like, do not stand on the rickety chair and attempt to do your home decorating.
Yeah, well, stand on the rickety table then. Let's push the table over.
I'm on top of the paladin. Just hold me up.
See, everything moves here.
I jumped on... Am I muted again?
No.
You're not muted. You're ignoring me.
I jump on the paladin. Just lift
you
me
jump
up.
On the...
okay. Yeah, 18. Dexterity check to just crawl up on her back.
Okay.
Like chicken style.
Okay.
Cool.
Coco.
Okay, you can see there. Can you see the trapdoor if you scroll down a bit?
No, I reloaded even. It's frozen.
Yeah, we scroll down. Yeah, we can see it.
Okay, well, you can see a trapdoor in the ceiling.
Frank, please try to open it.
It opens. You can see it obviously leads up into the loft.
Okay, I climb up.
Okay. You see a very dusty loft, a couple of windows that obviously lead out onto, onto the roof. What do you do?
Is there anywhere to secure a rope?
I have some rope.
I guess you could rope too.
I guess you could tie it to the. You could probably tie it to like the hinges on the trapdoor or something if you wanted to.
You can tie it to yourself.
Yeah. That's not a good idea. I'm tiny, and my strength is 10. I'm gonna tie it to the hinges on the trapdoor then.
Okay.
21.
That's pretty good.
Throw the rope down.
Okay.
Let's go up.
Okay, you can put yourself up in the loft.
Sometimes you gotta go up to get down.
Yeah.
I was really expecting to see an exit from here.
Well, there are windows that lead out onto the roof. However, there's also, you see this trunk. And you see this.
Oh, wait. Ah, that's an enemy.
You see this rather transparent looking being. And he's like, oh. Hello.
Hey.
G'day.
What's that?
Well, I guess we are.
Good job.
Yes.
Give him a thumbs up.
Did it take you a long time to come up with that one?
Because you've come
a little bit transparent on it.
Yes, they do say they can see right through me. I take it to heart.
And who
What's
are you?
What's a goat like do? Like you doing over here?
I'm the ghost of Hope.
Bob Hope?
Yes. Yes, I'm where Hope comes to die.
I can help you to get to the light if you want.
Well, the light comes through the windows.
I mean, I can help you to be reborn through the light of Latander.
Yes, I'm sure you can, yes, very nice, thank you, yes, I'm sure you're happy the reading and all that, and you can feel like, just your...
Everything is evil here.
You can feel it, like your optimism is just draining from you.
Oh no!
Oh look, you're smoking a cigarette.
Very big.
So we're just passing through. You don't mind, Mr. Ghost?
You don't mind us passing through you, right?
You're quite welcome to pass through.
Then I walk past him.
She just walked right through my room.
Thank you.
Ooh, you're evil.
Ooh, no way.
You're an evil person.
Ooh,
I want to walk through the ghost.
Why can I control this?
Don't do that. He's like, don't do that. Don't walk through me. That's not nice.
We just ask you to permission to walk through, and you said yes.
I said you could. I don't want everyone walking through.
I'm gonna walk again.
Night, thank you.
That is so evil.
He's like, phew, I didn't like that. He's not very nice.
He is not very nice today, sorry.
No, he's a... What are you doing hanging out with that evil person?
I don't know. It's not always evil.
Too much chatting and not much getting away from here. Let me get this window open.
Okay. You're gonna try and open the...
Yeah.
Okay. How are you gonna open the window?
Like a straight up kick. Just in the middle.
So you're gonna kick it.
Come on, you have the deep tool.
Yeah.
Okay. Roll me just I don't know, your strength. Roll me an attack roll with your strength, add your strength bonus.
Minus one. Twelve.
Okay, well you just sort of crack it in the middle and oh dear. How much gold did you have left?
I have 61.
Oh dear me. You get a receipt, 61 gold pieces taken for damages to the window, with 5 gold pieces to be paid at a later date.
He you might know. Be evil, but that's evil.
Yeah,
that's beyond evil.
You have an overdraft.
Yeah,
I'm gonna take the rope.
No, nobody's wondering what's in this chest. Any chance? No.
They're just gonna charge you
chest?
For it anyway.
Yes, it's a chest.
Look, it's a chest. Hey, Mr. Ghostface. What's in the chest?
I wouldn't look in there if I was you.
You wouldn't look in there. Well, you're not me. Have you looked in there? You can't just look in there anyways, right?
I know what's in there.
And what's in there?
That's how he became a ghost.
I think I'm finally on the same screen.
Oh, you're here.
Are you? Okay.
I reloaded 3 times.
Okay.
He's like, yeah, I know what's in the chest.
No. So, would you mind telling us what's in the chest? I'm just curious, you know.
Negativity.
I don't need that. That's what made you so negative, huh?
It's where all the negativity goes.
Well,
negativity, like negative gold coming out of our pockets.
Yeah, probably that's where all the gold is. That's right.
Maybe.
That's where the gold is magically disappearing from our pockets when we do bad stuff here, huh? All right.
I'm stuck on the first floor here.
I mean, hey, is it locked? I'll take a gander. I'm really curious what's in the box.
What's in the box? Hold on a minute.
It's Gwyneth Paltrow's head.
Oh shit. I'll take it as a souvenir. It's my new arcane focus.
That's an interesting focus.
Hold on a minute.
Oh no, the chest is smoking.
Hold on.
Hold on, mate. I'm just getting a bit clunky at my end as well.
It's alright.
Okay. So, when you open it.
Oh, is it the pocket dimension?
You see a big red bag.
Look, I found the gold. Big red bag, you say?
Yeah.
Alright. What if I try to shake it up a bit? Like, is it like doing the money sound?
It does the money sound.
It does the money sound. Guys, I think I found our gold.
Alright.
Yeah. So
So, Mr. Ghost, why is this so negative about this? There's money in there. It's supposed to be positive.
Yeah.
Or is it your gold?
No.
No?
Then what are you doing here?
Hmm?
What are you doing here?
Yeah.
I'm just haunting this lot.
Well,
I just came into being from all the negativity that you get in the Lord. There's ghosts. You mean you didn't find the skeletons in the closet? There's ghosts. You know there's ghosts in every law office.
In every law office, yeah.
Well, you're not doing a great job at haunting this place.
Yeah, you should go downstairs, maybe.
Yeah.
There's nothing.
He looks at you, Saber, with a horrible expression, and he's like, your blood runs cold, and he's like, would you like me to?
I'd like to see you try, and I flip him up.
Oh, boy. Okay, corner.
Daichi, are you going to sleep, buddy? Okay. Okay, so you're flipping the bird.
Yeah.
I really wouldn't do that if I was you. Why don't you take the bag? The red bag. For all the money. You know you want to.
Take the money? I mean, why not?
Beaver, mate. Beaver. He's trying to persuade you, but he's not doing a very good job of it. I don't know, though. You roll me a charisma save?
Everyone?
No, just Beaver.
Ah. Oh.
Another natural
20. You just brush him off. He's like, yeah. take the bag.
Let's keep taking everything.
Bag.
Normally I would, but these people, man, I just don't like them. And I kick the window again.
Okay. Strength check, please.
Can you go into minus gold?
1, 7. Why do I roll my nat 20?
Okay, you get another bill for 54 gold pieces in damages.
Yeah.
To be taken.
You 59 gold
now. Yeah.
So, Mr. Ghost.
You know you have the thief tools, right? I mean, you can try to open the window with a breaker.
Well, that's burglary as well. But Mr. Ghost, why do you want us to take this money? This is dirty money, right?
This is negative money.
Yeah, right? I mean, look, I don't mind taking it.
You can take it, or will it take you?
Huh?
Quick, everybody, get in the bag.
Alright, well.
Wait, is it a
I get mimic? Closer to the ghost with my axe up. And I say, okay, I'm tired of this. Or you tell us exactly what is going on, or I'm going to show you the light.
Yes, go him.
Oh, I'm scared.
I show him the light.
I'm scared of the paladin. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? I don't know what's going on, but I think you might be out of your depth.
NPC, how would you like to carry this gold back home?
Let someone else do it.
Yeah, the problem is I'm not strong enough. I would carry it.
I have 10 strength.
Yeah, well, you win.
Oh no. I don't even think I can carry that much gold.
Yeah, right, that's a lot of fucking gold.
Strength check. Ooh, natural 20.
Yeah. We could build a whole new bar for you. Let's refurbish the current one, you know.
What's that?
Did we get the ghost?
Yeah, it was the ghost.
It was the ghost. Okay.
So what are you gonna do? Are you gonna take the bag?
Yeah, take
guys,
the bag.
We're not here to steal. Well, we were here we to
are
steal
here to
one
steal.
Thing.
We are here to
steal. Literally here to steal.
Yeah.
It's true, like, these people are evil, but stealing from evil doesn't make it good.
Yeah, but it does. Maybe
how?
This is, well, look, just think of it as Robin Hood. This is good people's money. So we're taking from the evil and give to the poor.
Are you going to
which
give
is
to
us?
The poor?
Huh? Yeah. I consider myself Robin Hood at this point. Yeah.
I always carry a glass cutter when I'm cutting glass.
I say, let's take this gold.
Okay, you can take it.
Okay,
let's
cool.
see what happens.
Alright. Are you gonna smite
the
ghost?
If it attacks us.
Okay, I don't think it will. Alright.
All right, somebody help me open this window.
Well, help yourself. You have the tools.
Fine. I'll take a look. And is there some like mechanism to open the window?
Yeah, there's like one of those handles on it, you know, that you open the window.
I was looking up.
You know, like. Yeah, like kind of easy.
All right. Well, if the window is open, we can just drop the bag down, and then follow it.
Yeah. Let's go out through the window.
All right.
What can we see out of the window? Is like the roof?
You see the roof. Hold on a minute. Are you okay. taking the bag with you?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Okay.
Linus.
Bag.
How much gold did you have?
Me?
All
like,
of you.
I had like 8.
Minus 59?
I have 4. I have 20. 23.
I have 74.
You find your pouches all have just gone very, very light when you pick up the bag. You hear this sucking sound like...
But it gets sucked into the bag, right?
Yep.
Okay, well...
This could be useful.
Yeah. We'll handle this later.
Okay.
Alright, so currently 0 gold. Got it.
Okay, so you find yourselves out on the roof.
Alright.
And that's where we're gonna have to call it a night.
Ah, okay.
Okay, gang.
Alright, thank you.
Alright, thank you, John.
Thanks,
I'll try to get this
mate.
Working better next
yes.
time.
Amazing art.
I'm still stuck on the second floor.
You're still stuck
reason.
On the second floor.
Yeah, it refreshed. But it keeps going back.
Who's that there? Ooh, wow. It's two of them.
Yeah.
Ay, ay, ay.
Yum.
Yes, there are two figures at either end of the roof, yeah. And they just sort of, as you climb out the window, they just sort of. You actually climbed out of this window, I think.
Ah, okay.
Oops. You're up there, yeah, you climbed out of this window. You find yourself up on the rooftops. And you've got a lovely view of the city around you.
And all the conveniently equal-sized buildings we can hop to over the small gap.
No.
We're not that lucky.
Actually, you can see you're outside the prison. You're near the law courts. You can see actually Marlowe's place, that blue roof across the way. That you remember is Marlowe's shop. There's the swappy seconds, but no, unfortunately, everywhere is just that little bit too far to jump.
So I have an idea. Two people jump up on top of somebody else, and I just revive the dead.
Well, you can.
We can do that next session.
You can do that next time.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, guys, thanks for hanging out.
No, thank you for the
Thank you, John. Great game.
Yeah, thank you very much.
As always.
Yeah. Yeah. I will see you all. Hopefully see you next week, and maybe we'll all be meeting in person soon.
Yeah, finally.
Maybe I'll try Chrome next time, too. It would probably make Roll20 work better.
Maybe.
Alright. Alright, well, take care, guys.
Take care.
Okay, have a good week. Four.